Kamikagama says, I have seen, not only Kamikagama saying, I have seen my grandfather. Kamikagama says 10 trees, bamboo stick, sorry, drumstick tree, papaya tree, 10 trees he says, should be around, Mahasadashiva says, should be around your house and the cow. You will never be hungry, you will never need to sleep in hunger. How he says, exactly like that, I have seen houses existing in Indian villages. Means each unit is complete self-sustaining for all the fundamental needs. I have seen my grandfather carrying bags of cotton seed, giving and taking the clothes and coming back. For all basic needs, a small unit becomes self-sustaining. And when the British studied Indian system, that was shocking for them. Every village is self-sufficient unit. That is why we made road only for pilgrimage purpose. Kashi to Rameshwaram, Rameshwaram to Kanyakumari, only for pilgrimage purpose we made road. We did not make road for any transportation of goods because every village is self-sufficient. We don't need food transportation and any other transportation. All other items only needed for luxury was transported. For day-to-day running, you don't need any transportation. For life to exist, food, medicine, emergency services, you don't need transportation. Self-sustaining units. They want to break that. That is why they destroyed our goshalas. They destroyed our agriculture. They destroyed our schools. Mahadeva says in Kamikagama, a village should have naturally formed honeycombs. The drainage, hen, duck should drink that water and survive. I was thinking, what is the meaning of all that? If the drainage water drunk by ducks and hen and they survive, means the whole thing is organic. There is no chemical in that. In your cooking, in your day-to-day living. If the natural bees are growing honeycombs, means that air pollution, understand, for a bee to survive, four things are required. The ground cannot be polluted. In polluted ground, if a flower grows, if the bee drinks that honey, it will die in few seconds. First thing, the land has to be pure. Second thing, from that land, the flowers which come up, they have to be pure. Means air has to be pure. Third, the water source has to be pure. Only then the honey which comes in that water, in that flower will be pure. So the bee can drink that honey, flourish and build honeycomb. Understand, bee does not fly more than 1.5 kilometers in their whole lifetime. They live in 1.5 kilometer region only. Maximum 1.5 kilometers. Moving them beyond 1.5 kilometers is a big job. It's almost like they lose their balance if they fly continuously more than 1.5 kilometers. So within 1.5 kilometers only they will settle down. If there is a place, natural honeycomb farming, Sadashiva says, that is a blessed ground. Start living there. I reside there. Now I understand why he says what he says. Look around our campus and count how many natural bee combs, honeycombs. And he says, hang mango flower. Understand, not fruit, flower. Mango flower. Before becoming fruit, that mango will give a flower, small flowers. Mango flower, neem flower, rice paddy. Hang all that in your door frame. Sparrows should come and eat them. Only then you can live in that house. Means, sparrows have very sensitive lungs. If the air pollution level in that area is very pure, only then the sparrows will come and live there, survive there. If the sparrows are not living or chirping, that place air pollution is not conducive for human lungs to breathe. Go to all cities. Show me a single sparrow in Chennai or Bangalore inside. Single sparrow. Forget about Delhi. Delhi, even you cannot survive. No, Delhi, actually, you have to develop a new lung to survive. I was shocked, actually. Mahadeva gives instruction to in agriculture. In the Vasanta time, Vasanta is Chitra, Chitra month. Chitra Masa. In Chitra month, if the dogs don't mate in the street, go and sprinkle neem oil in your agriculture ground, paddy, he is telling. Spray neem oil in your agriculture land if the dogs in your streets don't mate on Vasanta month. Means something is wrong in your grain. Because they are going to eat only what you left. What? In those days there was no separate dog food store. What you eat, the remaining you feed the dogs. That's the way the pet dogs are grown. Or the street dogs also. If you keep the food inside the house, they are called pet dogs. If you keep food outside the house, they are called stray dogs. That's all. This is what I call organic life. Even in Kailasa, to retain the purity, how much we struggle, only we know. And whatever somehow gets mixed impure, to remove that from your body and detoxify your body, from neem juice to haritaki, and cleaning up. Mahadeva says, walk on the ground without shoes, without chappal. Bhuma Devi will take the body scan of you, and whatever vitamins, minerals, the important ingredients required for your body which you don't have, she will add it in the food which is growing in that area. So eat that food, that is medicine. He says, biology. Please understand, geography is biology in Hinduism. Earth is not geography for us. It is biology. Bhuma Devi, conscious, alive. So when you walk on the earth without chappal, she scans your body and documents all the vitamins, minerals required for your body which you don't have for healthy life. And she adds them because she is conscious. She can produce anything by will. She adds them in the food, fruits, flowers, vegetables, trees happening in that area. Eat them, you will be healthy. I will document why I am doing what I am doing to the world and the benefits. It's not that I'm going to just speak and leave it. I'll document and bring it out with evidence to the world. Mahadeva says, if the bees are attacking you, take care of your cow food. Means, if the bees sit on the cows and drink their blood, they will attack human beings. They will be violent. If a cow does not eat any artificial food, eats only the organically grown, that blood will not have a salt enough for the bee to sit and drink. It's artificial things you add in the cow's food makes their blood drinkable for the bee. So if cows are grown organically, the bees in that area will not attack human beings. All these bullet points from Agama, I'll release it to the world. I'll put all of them as bullet points and release it to all you guys. Why we are doing what we are doing? Why we are doing what we are doing?